As soon as I drove on the track, I kind of understood what it was about. It's backside puckering stuff, isn't it?
Where you just, if you can pull off a top step of the podium there, it's going to live with you for a long time.
Just walking out onto the podium there is something that you just can't explain. I mean, there's a thousand or so people there crowded around the podium, and it is truly a special moment. It just makes that, absolutely 100% worth it, and that's what we go there for. Once you've had the taste of it once, it just gives you that motivation to come back and try and achieve that again. I mean, last year with the race to the flag with Lowndes would have showed that. We'd both been on that top step before and knew what it was like, and it was a good battle.
Seeing your name on that list, I mean, you got your name on there with Brock, Moffat, Johnson, Gagan, all these greats of the sport that, you see Tander down the bottom there. It's just a massive, massive feeling of being part of history, I guess.
Well, the first day of the 2007 Supercheap Auto Bathurst 1000 has been fascinating. It's been painful, but overall it's been pretty balanced in the top 10 there. 5 Fords, 5 Holdens represented, and 8 different teams, with Mark Winterbottom setting the fastest time, 207.1481. Our provisional pole sitter is with Mark Beretta.
Well, Mark Winterbottom, congratulations. Last out in the top 10 shootout. You fought hard for it. Waited to the last minute too.
Yeah, we did. We timed that session nicely, and we made a small change before the last run, and our car is in good shape. So, I was puffing on that lap. I don't know if it was excitement or I was getting tired. I don't know which one, but that was good. I think there's a little bit left in it, but it's really good shape for tomorrow. But now we've got to do it over one lap, not a half-hour session. So, we're looking good, and looking forward to tomorrow.
And I did hear a whisper that you called into the team and apologised because that hot lap could have been even quicker.
Yeah, I dropped a wheel and did a couple of burnouts on the straight there, and lost a tenth and a half or 2/10. So I was looking for a 6 and got a 7-1. But I was a bit apologetic because you work all this lap and you do 22 corners or whatever it is, and you get to the 23rd and make a mistake. So, we're in a good shape for tomorrow, and the car's really strong. And the good thing about our team is, I got to drive the car, but Richo could have done the same job. So we've got two guys that are in a good spot, and either one could have done the job.
Frosty, so far so good. Well done.
Thanks, mate. Cheers.
Garth Tander, pretty good run today. Congratulations. Second's not bad.
Oh yeah, we're happy with that. There's no headlines to be had tonight. It's all about Sunday. So. Car's really, really good. We were very good in practice this morning, and then good again in that second session. So, the track was getting faster and faster at the end of the session, and we sort of gave up halfway through. We were pretty comfortable.
It is an important thing to get into the top 10 shootout. It has such status, I suppose, at this event. And one of the good things is we reverse the order, so you'll just about know what everyone's doing and what you've got to chase. Is that a good or a bad thing?
No, it's a good thing, and the beauty about our car is I've been able to do my lap times on the first flying lap, so that's good for the shootout. It means we're getting good tyre temperature and understanding what the car needs, so looking forward to the shootout tomorrow.
Well done, good luck.
Thank you.
Yes, Garth Tander will go out second last in the shootout, with Mark Winterbottom, of course, to go out at the very end. But get this, Neil Crompton, Mark Scaife is before Tander, so there's a 5-time pole sitter. Before them is Craig Lowndes, who's been on pole here twice. And before them also is Greg Murphy, who owns the pole lap here and has done it 4 times as well, 4-time victor.
Well, I mean, the shootout's always fabulous here. It's got a great atmosphere and everybody looks forward to it and loves it. I thought it was a fascinating qualifying session today. All the right guys are in there. Maybe a couple of fellas that we thought we might have seen a little more strength from, but how quick were they? Pretty warm conditions, very blustery. Thought we might have broken a 6, but not quite. Tantalisingly close. Garth Tander, as you said there a few moments ago, was very strong in that morning practice session. So, and Mark Winterbottom said that he had a little more left up his sleeve. I think they, conditions being right, might sneak into a high 6 tomorrow, and that's pretty interesting.
Okay, just quickly, I know that you never ever want to tip this race because you simply can't, but did we get any answers out of today?
No.
You any closer?
No, because it's such a random thing, isn't it? There's so many different elements involved in getting a result at this racetrack, but it's so, so close. It'll get down to strategy and how much everybody's got to use fuel and use brakes and all kinds of things. But for the moment, we're still locked in this whole thing over one lap. Then we change focus into Sunday for 161 laps. Totally different deal. But for the one lap scorcher, very hard to pick at the moment. But Winterbottom and Tander, every time you look at those guys through each of the sessions, they're always up there straight away. Even on the out lap, straight away they've got pace. They do their first flying lap, straight away they've got pace. That bodes pretty well. Scapey's had to chase the car a little bit harder to be in there, but certainly cars 1 and 6 rock solid at the moment.
Well, FPR did a lot of work to make sure that Stephen Richards and Mark Winterbottom, their double A drivers, could be in car number 6, and it's paid dividends so far. Winterbottom has provisional pole position. Make sure you join us tomorrow, midday all states, and of course Sunday from 7 a.m. Eastern time. We will go right through to the finish and then beyond. It's a big, big weekend. It's the best weekend in Australian motorsport. I'm Matthew White. On behalf of Neil Crompton and our crew, make sure you join us tomorrow because it's shootout time at the Bathurst 1000. Somehow I couldn't stop myself. I just wanted to know how it felt. Too strong, I couldn't hold on.